Hi everyone, welcome you all. This is Pavan from SDET channel. In this video, I'm going to show you Cypress environment setup on macOS. Now let's get started. So as a first step, we need to download Node JS along with Npm. And basically we need this environment to install Cypress later. Now we'll start step by step. So first we need to download Node JS and Npm, and which should be a prerequisite. Now go to macOS. So here we need to first download the software, and to download the software, just go to the browser, and I'm opening my Chrome browser on my Mac, and here just type download Node.js and search for it. Now just go to this link, download Node.js, and once you go to this particular website, we can download an installer. I just click on this link. Now you can just navigate to this particular website, and here you can find something called two installers you can find. So one is macOS and the other one is source code. And just I'm clicking on macOS installer. So now it is downloading one .pkg file. Now let it complete the download part. So once it is downloaded, now you can just open this or else you can just go to the download section and you can see that show in finder. All right, so here it is downloaded. I'm just closing this window. So now this is my downloaded installer. So node 12.13.1.pkg. Now we need to run this to install Node.js. Now I'm just running it. So you can just click on, double click on this. So once you double click on this, it will start running your Node.js software. Just a moment. Okay, now you can see it is open a window and startup window, and then we can proceed with the installation. So just click on continue. Now it shows some license agreement. Just click on continue. Now it is asking for license agreement again. Just click on agree. So after that, again click on continue. So again now install. So once you click on install, it will start installing Node.js. Now it is in progress. Now it is asking a username and password. So I'm just providing my macOS password. After that, click on install software. So now it is starting Node.js software on my macOS. So let's wait for a few seconds. Once it is completed installation, so we can check the version. It is take some few seconds of time. So let's wait for a few seconds. Right, so now it is completing the installation. Yeah, now it is completed. So once it is completed, so these are the default locations where exactly Node.js and Npm is installed. All right. So after that, we can just close this window. And now my Node.js successfully installed. I can just close it. And or else I can just keep this package open, or I can just move it to the trash. So now I can just close it. So now let me open my terminal and check whether Node.js properly installed or not. I can just check the version here. I'll say node-version. So this will give you version. So I'll say node-version. Yeah, now it gives you version number of node. Okay, so this is how we can cross check whether the node is properly installed or not. So this is a basically node.js environment setup. So once you set this node.js environment setup, then we need to go for the next step. So here to install Cypress on top of Node.js, we need to create a Cypress working folder. And inside the working folder, we need to have package.json file. We need to generate this file inside the folder. And what is the use of this file is we need to specify some dependencies, and then Node.js will read that file and accordingly it will download the software. So basically we can specify like protractor or Cypress or TypeScript. So these things we can download through package.json file. So in the Node.js environment, so if you want to download any JavaScript based frameworks, we need to use a package.json file. Now let's create a Cypress working folder as a second step. Now let's go to Mac again. So let's close this window. Now I'm just going to Finder. Now go to my home directory, and here I'm going to create a folder. So you already created one folder, or else you can create your own folder. Let me just create my own folder. So I will make that folder as a Cypress project later. So here you can see I already have some folder. or else I can just create one more folder. You can just move to trash. Now I'm creating a new folder. New folder, I will name it as Cypress Automation. So this is my folder name. Now I'm going to use this folder as a project. Now let's open this folder and open this folder. So once you open this folder, in this folder, we need to create a package.json file. So now we need to open this location in my terminal. So let's go to terminal and inside this Pavan. So here I have created this folder, right? So you can just search for it. You can say ls and it will show you the location, the Cypress Automation. Now we need to go to inside this folder. Let's say cd Cypress Automation. I can say Cypress Automation. I'm just going to inside this folder. Now currently I am in Cypress Automation folder. Now if I say pwd, it will show you the location. So here I am going to this particular folder I'm going to use as a Cypress project. Now we need to run, we need to just create a package.json file. That's the next step. So once you created your folder structure of working folder as a project, then we need to generate package.json and then we can install Cypress. So generate package.json. How to generate package.json inside the folder? So here we need to just add one small command we need to run, that is npm. So npm we already installed along with the Node.js, so we have to use that command. So npm init. This is a command which will generate a package.json file. Now press enter. So again, it is asking the package name. So here I can just give some package name. I'll say Cypress Automation. Now enter. It is asking for version. You can have a default version as it is. Press enter. Now description, if you want to provide some description, you can provide to this project or else you can leave it empty. Then index also, we can leave it empty for now. Test command, we can just leave for now. Git repository, keywords, and other, you can provide something. Your name and then license, we can just ignore. Press enter. Now finally, it is generated one package.json file in the same folder. Now this is structure of the JSON file. And currently we don't have any dependencies in this. Okay, just a plain package.json. Now it is asking, is this okay? Yes. Now press enter. So now it is created. If I say ls, now you can see package.json file is created. So now we need to go to the next step. So that is, we need to just go after creation of generated, after creation of package.json file. Now we need to use this particular file to install Cypress. Now let us go and see the Cypress website. What are the commands they have provided? So let's go to Mac again and open the Chrome browser. And here I'm searching for Cypress installation on Mac. Cypress installation on Mac. I'm searching for it. Now it will directly go to the website and go to the documentation section for Cypress. Now here they have given some requirements of Mac, Linux, and all Windows. There is only one command they have given, this one. So we already went to our path and here we need to run this command. npm install cypress --, save --dev. What basically this command will do is installs npm install cypress. This command will download Cypress dependency and available in package.json file. And then it will save that software in package.json file permanently. So this will command will download Cypress and install the complete Cypress software. So internally it will use the package.json file which I have discussed here. So what is basically package.json will do is it is just like a pom.xml file in Maven project. When you're working with the Java projects, we use Maven project and pom.xml where we dependencies are added, and then automatically it will download related jar file. So similarly, so our node also, Node.js also will download required software based on package.json file. Whatever software we have specified inside the package.json, it will download. But currently we haven't specified any Cypress related dependency in the package.json. But what will happen is by default, this command will download Cypress dependencies and add them to your package.json file. And that will save permanently. Okay, so we need to run this particular command to download Cypress and install. Let me just copy this command and I will run the same command on the folder which we have created as a project, right? So here we need to run. So wherever the package.json file is present in the same folder, I'm just running this one. Paste it over here, then press enter. So now it will download Cypress and it will install. It will take some time, so let's wait for a few seconds. And once it is completed, and we'll see further. It takes a few seconds of time, so let's wait for some time. Now you can see it is trying to download Cypress, and then it will unzip the Cypress, and then finally it will finish the installation. So download Cypress is completed. Now it is unzipping the Cypress. Yes, now it is completed installation. So we'll just go up and we can see here it will go up. So downloaded Cypress is completed, unzipped Cypress, and finished installation. So the Cypress is by default installed in this particular location, right? So this is how we need to download and install Cypress on top of Node.js. Now, after this, so now we have done Cypress environment setup ready. Now we need an editor to write our Cypress automation scripts. So here, Visual Studio Code editor is very popular one to work with the Java-based, JavaScript-based frameworks. So even for Cypress also, we can still use that particular editor. So Visual Studio Code editor, I'm going to download now. So let's see how we can download this. And again, just I can just close this window for now. Now go to the browser and here search for Visual Studio Code for Mac. Right, so now go to this one, download Visual Studio Code for Mac, Linux or Windows. And from this website, you can just download Mac related one is available. So Visual Studio Code for Mac, just click on this one, the third option. Now it will start downloading Visual Studio Editor. So now we can start downloading this. It is almost 81.9 MB. So once it is downloaded, then we will see how we can work with them. So let us complete the download process. All right, so now it is downloaded. So once you download it, just go and show in Finder. So this is a downloaded software. Basically, it is a zip file. Now right click and just open it. This is basically a zip file, so just you can open. So once you open, it is expanding. And once it is done, now we get the one app. So Visual Studio Code.app. So once you open this app, just click on this one and it will launch Visual Studio Code Editor. So it is launching here. So it is saying open. So open it and now you can see here. So Visual Studio Code Editor is started. So this is a Visual Studio Code Editor and you can just close the welcome screen. So this is a starting point. Okay, this is a starting screen you can see here. So here, once you install Visual Studio Code, so it will not comes under applications. If I just go to Launchpad, you should able to see that in this list, right? So we cannot see anywhere else. So we need to add that into our application. So for that, what we can do is, we can just close this once again, and we can just move this one into applications. You can just drag and drop into applications like this. So once it is done, so it is now part of your application. So this is a Visual Studio Code.app. Now we can just open it. Now we can just open this one. So this is a Visual Studio Code Editor. So we already created one project folder, right? In the step number two, create Cypress working folder. And that folder we need to open in the Visual Studio Code Editor because that folder acting as a project. Now we are going to create all Cypress scripts inside that folder. Now again, in the Mac OS, in the Visual Studio Code Editor, I need to just open that one. How to open, just go to the file. We need to open the folder. So let me just open the folder. So just go to Explorer and open. There are no open folders, so just click on open folder. Now we already created that inside my Pavan directory, right? So here you can see Cypress automation folder. I'm just clicking on open it. Right, so now my project setup is ready. So this is my project setup. You can find all the package.json and everything. You can just close the welcome screen. So this is a folder I have created, and all Cypress related automation scripts we can create inside the project, right? So this is how we need to set up Cypress environment on macOS. All right, so that's all for this video, guys. Thanks for watching.